Sande Charles with Baseball Census, and I'm joined by Yankees prospect Justus Sheffield. Justus, such an exciting time to be a young player with the Yankees. So much success, but how exciting is it hearing your name in the next wave of guys coming through?
You know, it's pretty mind-blowing to hear that it's getting closer and closer. You know, I got drafted in 2014, so seems like it's been a long road, but you know, to finally hear, you know, your name with you know, guys, especially in this organization in the minors, you know, we got a big wave of guys, you know, coming through. You know, that's been the big talk lately, so you know, it's been good.
Now, you were in the big trade with Andrew Miller, and you went from Cleveland to the Yankees. What was that trade like?
Yeah, it was pretty wild, because I didn't think I was going to get traded. I at first actually thought I was getting traded for Jonathan Lucroy. Okay. And then, you know, that trade got waived, and I wasn't a player to be named in that. So, you know, I was actually starting the next day and wasn't going to worry about it. So I was like, I'm just going to go to sleep. And then went to bed, woke up to our head of minor league player development, and he pretty much called me and said I was traded to the Yankees. So, you know, I was kind of taken back. I was kind of sad at first, because, you know, I've been with that organization, had good relationships, things like that. But also, it's the pinstripe, so, you know, what's not to like?
Did it help at all that one guy going with you, Clint Frazier, was in that trade as well? Now you guys are at the Yankees. How was that relationship, and did that help?
Yeah, for sure, because you know, I've known Clint since 2013, because him and my brother, they played together in high school and things like that, or against each other. So you know, I've heard his name, and then when I got drafted, you know, he was a familiar face when I was with the organization. But you know, it helped, because coming over, I didn't know anyone.
Yeah.
Didn't know what to expect, so you know, we were on the phone with each other, and we lived with each other through spring training, so it was a big help.
Now, speaking of, you mentioned one brother, and then a brother that plays for minor leagues, but with the Dodgers. Mm-hmm. Is there a little rivalry? Do you guys talk, especially both teams right now in the postseason? How is that?
Yeah, at first I feel like there was more of a rivalry, kind of him getting drafted and him saying he was going to make it before me, things like that. But now we just kind of talk and talk about the game, talk about our outings. You know, but definitely there's a lot of trash talk going on right now with, you know, possibly our two teams facing each other in the World Series. So.
Now, I did read that your first time ever visiting New York was last year. You bought your own ticket to the Yankee game to be a fan.
Yeah.
What was that experience like, and did you picture yourself out there on the mound?
Nah, I mean, it was wild, because, like you said, it was my first time, and I did have to go to StubHub and get my own tickets. It was pretty crazy, because I didn't, you know, this past year was my first time at Big League camp, so
yeah.
I didn't know any of the Big League guys to kind of, you know, ask if, you know, they could hook me up. But I was good. I went with one of the other players while I was in Trenton, and you know, we had a great time. But yeah, as soon as I walked in, I couldn't even. It's hard to imagine yourself out there. You know, for the biggest thing for me was, you know, the three upper deck levels. So I was like, man, if I'm down there, it's pretty wild to look up in the stands. But you know, I'll be definitely excited to be a part of that.
Now let's talk a little bit. Doing research and watching a lot of your videos, you talk about your size, and it's something that you had to kind of overcome. But you have overcome it, and you're doing it. What would be some advice to guys that might maybe are struggling with that, and how did you overcome it?
Yeah, I've heard it, you know, growing up through high school, things like that, especially from the draft scout standpoint. You know, he's a little undersized is the term that they use, but you know, it's just that adds fuel to the fire.
Yeah.
You know, it just allows me to go out there and prove people wrong, and that's probably one of my favorite things to do, just because you know, you get to go out there, compete, be a bulldog on the mound, and at the same time show people up, show people wrong. So but yeah, I am kind of sure you could tell she's almost as tall as me, but she got the heels on.
I do have heels on, and I keep sinking.
But you know, I just shake it off and play my game.
What are you hoping to work on, or maybe perfect here at Arizona Fall League?
For me, well, I got hurt this year, tore my oblique, so I missed 2 months. So I was talking to the coordinators about getting out here and get my innings in. That was the main thing. But also, I want to go out here and, you know, I want to do well. You know, a lot of people, they might take this as time to work on things, and obviously I'm going to continue to try and develop on my pitches and command and things like that. But, you know, obviously I want to go out here and I want to do well. Facing, you know, guys, other top prospects from other teams, and guys that I've never faced before, but I hear about them all the time on, you know, Twitter and things like that. So it's been fun to get out here and compete against them.
You're back in Arizona. I know Indians spring training is out here. Yankees is not. It's in Florida. How different is Florida from Arizona?
Well, for one, I might have to say I like Arizona a little bit better because temperature's a little humid down there. You know, it was my first spring training down there. Well, when I was with the Indians, I was in Goodyear. So I remember saying, man, Florida would be great because you got the beaches and things like that. But then once I get down there, man, it's brutal playing. It's brutal playing down there. But, you know, it's been nice, especially this time of year up here. You know, it's incredible weather and, you know, couldn't ask for anything more.
Awesome. Thank you so much for Justus Sheffield. I'm Sande Charles with Baseball Census.